care and cleaning of the Enfield family of muzzle-loading rifles. Like most things firearms-related, there's more than one way to clean your Enfield rifle musket. This is a simple demonstration of how I clean my Enfields. Part 1. Disassembly and cleaning of the barrel. Here are the materials used for cleaning. Some simple dish soap in a bucket, a tool roll, in this case one that I made myself, contains a pouch for a set of 3 turn screws, among other miscellaneous tools. These include a cleaning jag, nipple wrench, and mainspring vise. For preservation after cleaning, I use brake-free oil. For purposes of getting into all the little nooks and crannies that we'll find, a simple nylon toothbrush, a dental pick, a rag for wiping, some plumber's tape for redressing of the nipple once cleaned, cleaning patches, and to hold everything, a simple canvas haversack. This particular Enfield rifle, in this case a P-58 naval rifle reproduction by Parker Hale, has been fired with about 50 rounds put through it. This has left the barrel fouled, though not excessively, with additional fouling found around the breech area and nipple. Disassembly. The first step after proving safe is the disassembly. This will include removal of the lock and the 2 barrel bands. It's important to select the appropriate turn screw, making sure that the diameter and dimensions of the turn screw match the slot in the screw. This will prevent damage over repeated use. The 2 screws that hold the lock in place are traditionally known as side nails. They sit inside little brass cups, known as, of course, side nail cups. The 2 hold the lock firmly in place. Once the side nails are loosened, we can loosen the breech nail, which is the screw that goes through the barrel tang and into the trigger guard. With all of the side nails and the breech nail removed, we can then remove the lock. This is done by simply loosening, moving the lock to half cock first seems to make things a little bit easier. The same again from a different angle. Before removing the barrel bands, first withdraw the ramrod and lay it aside. As with the side and breech nails, ensure that your turn screw is of appropriate dimension for the screws holding the barrel bands tight. If the sling is loose, as in this case, it is not necessary to completely remove the screw in the front barrel band. Simply loosen it and slide it off the end of the barrel. Peculiar to the naval rifle and its artillery carbine cousin, there's a bayonet lug on the side of the barrel, and the barrel band must be rotated to clear that. If your Enfield rifle is equipped with battery barrel bands, as is this one, it's critical that you must ensure the proper turn screw dimensions for these small, rounded, and inset screws on subsequent barrel bands. Once the barrel band is loosened, it simply slides off the front of the rifle. The barrel can then be removed by simply lifting up and separating it from the stock. The same again from another angle. With the barrel removed, we can then remove the nipple. This is done with a nipple wrench and is sized appropriately for the dimensions of the lug on top of the nipple. In this case, I use a musket cap nipple of historical proportions. The nipple is fairly stiff once fired, but the application of plumber's tape during the cleaning process enables easy removal after firing. Once loosened with the wrench, it can be removed by hand. Cleaning of the barrel. The With the rifle disassembled, the next step is to give the barrel a good flush with hot water. You don't need any special tools to do this, just boil a kettle. However, I've fashioned a line of simple garden hose with a 90 degree nylon elbow in the end to facilitate water being put directly into the muzzle, and this is plumbed right into the hot water line. With the water running and good and hot, I hose down the breech area to loosen up the fouling deposits that are found there after firing. Once this is done, I simply use the same hot water and I fill the barrel up. Water will run out of the nipple hole. This ensures that the fouling starts to break up and become loose with the heat of the water. Typically, I let it run for a few seconds. The elbow in the end of the hose helps facilitate this. The next step is to give the barrel a good scrub. All I use is some simple dishwashing detergent in a bucket filled with the hot water that I've been using to prep the barrel with. Having soaked the barrel inside and out in good hot water, I'll now scrub the breech area with the nylon toothbrush, making sure to get into all the nooks and crannies around the breech area. A simple plunge and scrub. With the outside and the breech area clean, then plunge the breech into the hot soapy water and begin cleaning the inside of the barrel. I do this with a simple wet patch, soaked in the same soapy water that I've been using from the bucket, a range rod that I've dedicated for this purpose, and a 58 cal cleaning jag. Moving the cleaning rod up and down with the wet patch on the end will draw water through the nipple hole into the barrel. This scrubbing action will loosen the fouling deposits and also remove most of them by forcing the dirty water out through the nipple hole on the downstroke. As you can see, the patch usually comes out fairly clean. After this, a simple rinse, and we'll progress with the next step. With the barrel half full of hot water, we'll give it a rinse by plugging the muzzle and the nipple hole and rocking it back and forth, and then emptying it out. Most of the fouling will by this time be removed from the barrel, but it requires further cleaning with dry patches. A series of patches, which may number anywhere from 5 to 15, depending on how dirty your musket is, will be required to achieve the necessary results for storage. Pardon the poor lighting, but you can see the dirt and the fouling that comes off on our initial patches after rinsing and scrubbing. You repeat this process until the patch comes out clean to your satisfaction. As with all firearms cleaning, it will never be fully clean, especially immediately after firing. But when we arrive at a point similar to what's shown here, it's time to oil the bore and prepare it for storage. For this, I use break-free oil with a simple squirt on a patch and a few strokes in and out of the barrel. As you can see here, the patch is fairly clean and most of the discoloration on it is due to the oil not fouling. The same oil is then applied to outside parts of the barrel to ensure proper preservation and prevention of any rust, especially if you live in a damp climate. Not to mention the fact that we cleaned the bore and the outside of the barrel with hot soapy water, making sure this is removed is part of this step. Part 2 of this video will follow along with the cleaning of the lock, stock, and reassembly. Thanks for watching.